A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 15th June, on the front page you have Modi-Imran exchange pleasantries at Bishkek. So on the sidelines of SEO summit, PM Modi hints at Pakistan's role in backing terror also. Though he met the Prime Minister, pleasantries were exchanged as both are members to the SEO organization, Shanghai Cooperation Organization. Then this is India to impose retaliatory tariffs on 29 American goods. So after a year of talks on trade barriers to Indian steel and aluminium, the Indian administration, Indian government had announced tariffs, retaliatory tariffs on US goods, but it had deferred it and the deadline was extended. Now finally it has announced that it will be brought into effect from 16th June. So retaliatory tariffs will be imposed. This is going to affect these major products from USA, which is imported in India, like walnut, chickpeas, etc. Then this is medical services hit as doctors' agitation spreads. So this is doctors' agitation which is going on in West Bengal. So your hospital services have been affected in different parts of India as such, because doctors' agitation that began in West Bengal following an assault on medical professionals spread to national capital Delhi, Kerala, Telangana, Chandigarh and even Jammu and Kashmir now. And this is number of children killed by encephalitis in Bihar rises to 57. So the number of children dying due to suspected acute encephalitis syndrome in Muzaffarpur, which we had seen few days back too and was in news earlier to last year. So the number of deaths have increased for this year now. So that is a concern. State government has announced a new 100-bed ward and 6 ambulances. On page 9, you have probe agencies see similarities in murder of two rationalists. So, Narendra Dabholkar was shot dead in Pune in 2013 and Govind Pansare was killed in a similar way in Kolhapur. And now investigating agencies have told the Bombay High Court that they found some commonalities in the way both the rationalists were murdered. So, they'll soon start a countrywide search to look for the pistols used for the murder. Then below you have Chhattisgarh scribe held for false news on power outage. So a man from Chhattisgarh was arrested and charged with sedition for a social media post on power cuts in Chhattisgarh. And now a scribe, a journalist, has been held for publishing false news over electricity supply in Chhattisgarh. So again, you can see sedition and charges are imposed for social media posts. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Beyond the Wall. So it says, in defeat, the Gandhi family is looking for scapegoats without owning responsibility. So this is regarding defeat of Congress in the Lok Sabha elections. And then this is Full Discourse. So this says, SEBI's new framework for financial disclosure by credit rating agencies may not be enough. So this was in news yesterday, how credit rating agencies also have to clearly state the probability of default of the instruments they rate. As such, not just they announced the defaults, they announced the downgrade in ratings as such, but the probability of default also has to be announced now. This editorial says that the steps taken by SEBI are not enough. The lead article, reversing the scale of priorities. So this is regarding the Chennai-Salem highway case. So in this case, people are protesting against the highway here. And the case is before the Supreme Court. It says this case will now test judiciary's assessment of environmental and economic interests, because economic interests and environmental interests have to be balanced. So this article talks of that. And this is shaky building blocks. So this is regarding the draft national education policy. The article says it reinforces outdated ideas about the goals of foundational literacy program. So when children from 3 to 6 are also being included in the formal education system. So this article talks on how this is an outdated idea. On Saturdays on op-ed page, you have a ground zero coverage. So today the coverage is on GM brinjal, genetically modified brinjal, BT brinjal. So this GM brinjal cultivation, it was in news last month. In May 2019, that a farm in Haryana is producing genetically modified brinjal. So government insists that this is a one-off case, but activists are questioning the widespread problem it could be. So this is a coverage on this issue now. Then on page 13, you have Bukhari murder probe reveals grave security lapses. So this is regarding the journalist and editor of Rising Kashmir, Shujaat Bukhari, who was killed as such in 2018. So here you can see the investigation shows that there were grave security lapses in this murder. He was actually chased by bike-borne assailants and killed. Then here you have PM hits out at trade protectionism. So this is at the SCO summit in Bishkek. Prime Minister Narendra Modi said that we need a transparent, anti-discriminatory, all-inclusive system. And then you have below, show titles in Hindi, regional languages, TV channels told. So Information and Broadcasting Ministry has asked all satellite TV channels to display the casting, credits and titles of Hindi and regional language serials in the respective languages too, not just in English. Then on international page you have Riyadh repatriates Sri Lankans linked to Easter attacks. So the suspects have been arrested in Saudi city of Jeddah and they will be repatriated to Sri Lanka. They are linked to Easter Sunday attacks in Sri Lanka. Then on business page you have SEBI bars Pranoy Radhika Roy from NDTV board. So SEBI alleges that they concealed material info from shareholders while entering into loan agreements between 2008 and 2010. That is why now they have been barred from being part of NDTV board. And this is trade deficit widens to $15.36 billion in May 2019. Imports grew faster than exports and electronics, chemicals see good export growth. Then on page 16 you have WPI inflation, wholesale price index inflation at 2-year low in May 2019. Inflation in food articles basket was at 6.99%, down from 7.37% last month. This is the downward course of WPI inflation over the last 1 year. Every month it is released. Then on the last page you have women across Switzerland rise up for equal pay. So on average, women in Switzerland earn 20% less than men. So now they're demanding equal pay for equal work. So this gender discrimination and wage gaps as such is being protested against. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.